In previous video, we have seen that the pyridine is aromatic heterocyclic compound. And in this video, we have to focus on these three examples. Let us take the first example of pyrrole. In pyrrole, we have four carbon atoms with one nitrogen as a heterocycle. And on this nitrogen, we have one lone pair of electrons. All these four carbon are sp2 hybridized. So let us go ahead and write free p orbital like this. Now let us go ahead and check the steric number of this nitrogen. That can be calculated with the help of our same formula which we use in previous video. That is, total number of sigma bonds present on this nitrogen is 3, plus the lone pair present on nitrogen is 1. So steric number is 4. It means that this nitrogen seems to be sp3 hybridized, and that is against the Haeckel's rule for aromaticity. It means that one must show the resonance structure of this pyrrole. It means that the lone pair which is present on this nitrogen, it take parts into delocalization like this, and the negative charge will go on that carbon atom. So here we can write the resonance structure of this pyrrole like this. So let me draw the structure. So we have nitrogen over there. We must write the double bond between this carbon and the nitrogen, and we have negative charge on this carbon. This double bond will remain as it is. We have bond with hydrogen, and we must write the formal positive charge on this nitrogen. Now here we can calculate the steric number of this nitrogen. So this steric number of this nitrogen is equal to the total number of sigma bond. So this is 1. Out of these two bond, one is pi and one is sigma. So this is second, and we have third sigma bond with hydrogen. So 3, plus total number of lone pair of electron. Here there is no lone pair of electron. So 3 plus 0 equal to 3. It means that it is sp2 hybridized. And as we know that when there is sp2 hybridized, we must write the free p orbital on this nitrogen atom. It means that whatever the lone pair of electron is present on this nitrogen, this is actually get delocalized. So I can show this lone pair of electron like this. This get delocalized into the ring like this. Now we can calculate the total number of pi electrons. So here 2 plus 2 plus these 2 electrons, that is the lone pair of electrons, and therefore we have 6 pi electrons. It means that it follows Haeckel's rule for aromaticity, and that's why the pyrrole is aromatic in nature. Similarly, let us go ahead and check out whether furan is aromatic or not. Now in this particular furan, we have 4 carbon atoms and 1 oxygen. On oxygen, we have 2 lone pair of electrons. All these 4 carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized, so one can write the free p orbital on this carbon atom like this. Now here we can calculate the steric number of this oxygen. Now 2 sigma bonds plus 2 sigma bond plus we have 2 lone pair of electrons, so is equal to 4. It means that it is against the Haeckel's rule for aromaticity. So let's go ahead and draw the resonance structure for this furan. So one lone pair which is present, it will get delocalized like this, and we have now negative charge on this carbon atom. So we can write the resonance structure of the furan like this. So we have double bond as it is. We must write one double bond like this, with one lone pair of electron with positive charge, and we have negative charge on this carbon atom. Now here we can calculate the steric number. So steric number equal to, now here in this case we have two sigma bond. So one is with this oxygen and other one is with this again carbon atom. Out of these two, that is one is sigma and one is pi, plus lone pair of electron here. Now we have one lone pair of electron, so it means that it is sp2 hybridized. When oxygen is sp2 hybridized, so we can write one p orbital like this, and there is one lone pair of electron which is present on the oxygen, and the other lone pair, so that lone pair I can show over here, and this lone pair get delocalized into the ring. So it means that again it has 6 pi electrons, and the furan is aromatic in nature. Now let's look towards the thiophene. In this case also, this lone pair of electron, if you calculate the steric number, so steric number of this sulfur is again 4. So this lone pair of electron will get delocalized and will have the resonance structure like this. So we can write the resonance structure of thiophene like this. We have sulfur. This double bond will remain as it is. We must write one double bond over there, and the lone pair on sulfur with positive charge, and there is negative charge on this carbon atom. Now if you calculate the steric number of this sulfur, so this is equal to, now we have sigma bond like this and this, so out of these two, one is pi, so 2 sigma bond plus one lone pair of electron. So it means that we have 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. So let's go ahead and draw these 3 p orbitals on these carbons, as well as we have on sulfur also. So now we can write the lone pair of electron on this sulfur, and the one more lone pair of electron I will show like this, and this will get delocalized into the ring, and that's why we have 6 pi electrons in this ring, and therefore it follows the all conditions as well as the Haeckel's rule for aromaticity. That's why thiophene is aromatic.